Pele, Cotopaxi, and Katla. Each of these are considered to be potentially dangerous volcanoes that represent the most consistently highly explosive volcano on each of three different continents. What I mean by this is based on the sheer number of highly explosive eruptions they have each produced since the year 9700 BCE, which rated on the volcanic explosivity indexes 4 or higher, translating to at the very low end the 1902 eruption of Pele. Given their frequency of such major eruptions, each having produced 21 major eruptions during that time span, it is not a surprise that they are locally well known. But what if I were to tell you that few people have ever heard of one of a particular continent's third most consistently explosive volcano, despite the fact that some people live in fairly close proximity to it? What I'm referring to is a viscous lava dome complex within the nation of Colombia known as Cerro Bravo. Cerro Bravo is quite distinctive not only because of the 8 major eruptions it has produced during the Holocene, but also because it has produced no other eruptions during this time span. In other words, whenever the Cerro Bravo volcano has recently erupted, it has always produced a plinian eruption with a volcanic explosivity index of a 4 or 5. The last such eruption did not occur too long ago either, but we don't have an exact date, only an estimate of this eruption occurring around the year 1720. A recent scientific paper even indicated that its highest of 3 risk areas that could theoretically experience pyroclastic flows during future eruptions extends as far as 13.3 kilometers or 8.3 miles from its summit. But why is this volcano so explosive? As a quick reference, Cerro Bravo is the second northernmost active volcano in all of South America, which is located 143 kilometers west-northwest of the city of Bogota. It exists due to the offshore subduction of the Nazca Plate underneath the North Andes Plate. Partial melting then occurred on the subducted crust, causing molten rock to rise upwards, intruding into the North Andes Plate before rising underneath western Colombia towards the surface, sometimes resulting in an eruption and thus eventually forming a chain of volcanoes. While there are no thorough studies I could find of Cerro Bravo's magma composition, I personally theorize that this volcano has an unusually high volatile content within its magma, including carbon dioxide and water content. When combined with the high viscosity of its primarily dacite lavas, the same as what Mount St. Helens typically erupts, it creates a recipe for plugs to form and then explode in major eruptions. The Cerro Bravo volcano has been intermittently erupting for 230,000 years, with its first phase of construction ending in the destruction of the stratovolcano which existed with it collapsing into a 2.6-kilometer-wide caldera now seen at the southern end of the overall volcano. Subsequent activity across the next more than 100,000 years rebuilt a portion of the stratovolcano, with eruptions occurring from its central crater sending lava flows and pyroclastic flows in multiple directions. A single major explosive eruption in 5176 BCE created a nearly 1-kilometer-wide crater alongside sizable viscous lava flows. Many of its Holocene eruptions produced sizable lava flows whether through lava domes or coulees. Its other 7 Holocene eruptions occurred at a complex of craters half a kilometer north of the aforementioned crater rim, creating lava flows and pyroclastic flows which traveled up to 9.5 kilometers distant. As you can see, the eruptive centers of this volcano have trended northwards over time, with the next eruption likely to occur at the same youngest set of craters or just slightly north of it. While Cerro Bravo has no glaciers on its edifice, the amphitheater shape of its youngest crater complex will naturally funnel many pyroclastic flows generated during future eruptions along the Perillo River to the north and then northeast. That is why its farthest away segment of its highest designated hazard zone during a future eruption is along the river southeast of Monte Bonito. While Cerro Bravo did produce some minor unrest in 2008 and 2009, nothing thankfully came of it. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron C for supporting my work.